I came up with that idea because I'm really a football fanatic and I watch every Nicolas game every Saturday. And that was actually the most important game because it's against the Barcelona. The good thing is that she came from Sydney and we had a few days from work and from university. So I was like, let's go, the three of us, let's support him because the bad thing is that he was injured. And I was like, let's support him, let's print his face on our t-shirts. And I think that he was very, very surprised and happy. And you know, that's what family do.
We should mention that we were on a different side. We were amongst Barcelona fans.
Yeah, so. Because that was on Camp Nou, that wasn't in Pamplona. So. Many Barcelona fans were there, so they were like, okay, Vujinović, oh, Osasuna. but everything went great.
We had a Take Care Hermano on our t-shirt, so who is it? So it was really a great experience.
It was fun.
I think it's a very good thing to be part of that, passion, and to share those emotions.
Me and Milica went to Sofia, Bulgaria, to watch CSKA.
CSKA Sofia, yeah.
Yeah, and me and our mom went to Graz, Austria, to watch Sturm Graz. And all of us went to some of his games. And it was great. We felt amazing because we are supporting him and watching him. He likes to see us supporting him.
My parents were focused on developing our talents and Nicolas' talent. So we talk about football, we live football. We watch football, and we think Saturday. Actually it's a very smart game.
You can imagine how much we all love him, and he's like the only boy, and we are supporting him every single Saturday in our house. Football is like must.
Nicola started playing for Crvena Zvezda, so I don't know. We just like them and support them, and we go to Zvezda's matches.
It's probably because of Nikola. You know, he started there, his first games and first goals and everything.
Experience,
so yeah.
She's a passionate fan.
She went to the games when she was younger, and she still watches their matches, and she like at home cheering up for them. So
whenever Red Star is losing, she's like losers. Well,
back then, but
now she doesn't have problem, you know. Too.
And it's funny that she always sings their songs to Juliana's daughter and to Nicola's daughters.
Yeah.
She's teaching them, and I'm like, Mom, don't do that.
Nicola and I, especially the two, we listen R&B music, and when we are out in Belgrade, we always like let's go to R&B, and we don't know that many songs. We know a lot of songs in our language, but we are not like listening to them all the time. And then we have sometimes we have that one song that is special for us, you know, because of the melody. And then he loves that song so much.
But I think that also the lyrics are important part of the song.
Yes.
So it's kind of combination of the lyrics and the melodies.
Course.
And the lyrics are very sentimental.
And
Nicola is kind of sentimental.
Yeah, he's an emotional person.
Yeah. But he hides that sometimes, yeah. Like me. We're similar in that way.
So. Yeah, they're very similar, you know, like. Yeah,
and Milica and Juliana are similar too.
We had just the best childhood ever, the four of us. Can you imagine that, four kids?
That's what we think.
Yeah.
So it was a lot of fun.
Yeah, definitely. But that picture is one of my favorite, and I post it like all the time because it's so cute. And actually, you put this makeup on me.
That's artistic soul. So.
Older than Nicola, and we used to spend a lot of time together. What I remember is we liked creating our own plays, like theater. We used to sing, dance, and act. And he also played the piano.
Yeah.
Yes. He's very musical. Good. He's very a musical, perfect singer, very good voice. That was actually a couple of years ago. I was because I'm a pianist and. I do classical videos and all, and also pop videos. So that was that particular video was a combination of pop and classical. So
a salsa and classical Mozart.
That was just amazing.
So I asked Nicola and basically the whole family to join me. And they were let's do it. So
it was just amazing.
We had 18th century costumes. Yeah, it was very, very interesting.
Yeah, I saw that they were commenting like why she isn't on Twitter, but I don't know. Yeah. I have Facebook and Instagram, but I'm not that active.
She trains a lot. She's in sports also, and yeah. So university,
sports and stuff.
Gym.
Yeah, I love gym.
We arrived 2 days ago in Warsaw, and we had a great experience there. It's a beautiful
great time,
city.
Beautiful city.
Yeah.
And then we took the train to Poznan.
The train wasn't.
It was full, like completely full. And
well,
we were squeezed, like
sitting each other's in lab.
Oh
my God, we didn't expect that, you know, and actually we were late on the train.
When did we arrive? Like 30 seconds.
Exactly, 30 seconds. We were buying tickets and they were like, you have like in 10 minutes next train. And it took 10 minutes to print the cards. So we were like running and didn't see how the train looks like on the, outside.
Yeah,
but when we run inside, we were like, "Oh my God!"
3 hours. Like 70s.
Like 70s.
70 from
century.
But it's like in Serbia.
Yeah. But that's the same, like in Serbia. That's also experience.
And it's fun, and it's
no. We even don't have a train in Serbia.
Yeah, yeah. So
we don't have a train.
Yeah, we don't even have it. So.
We arrived late, so we didn't see a lot of stuff, but we went to the city center, and so it was very nice. A lot of people were there, and it was, I don't know, alive. Yeah. So we had a good time.
Few places.
Yeah, we changed a lot of places.
And the people are very warm.
Yeah. Yeah.
Very warm, very passionate.
Very upfront. Yeah. And passion.
So yeah, we had a great experience yesterday. Last night was very, very good.
Pereskizhikin.
It's like potatoes with this white cheese.
Yes, last night. Yeah, it was great. It was amazing. And what happened actually in the way? So we were talking and making fun because that's our that's our special.
I always talk nonsense in Serbian because I know that nobody understands
me. We laughed, we relaxed, we talked, and the guy said, well, I studied Serbian.
And we were like, oh no,
so that was funny.
And that is really
we were surprised, but then we realized that they love their club, they love their players, and so I guess they see us just as part of this whole family, you know, and I think that's amazing way to share, as I say, passion, and so. We don't see anything bad in that. Like the fans are very polite. Yeah. They are. We never received any rude message.
Yeah.
Like they are fully respectful. So very we were quite.
I'm so surprised. And I really enjoyed it because. I'm in Nicola's career, like I already said, I'm really a football fanatic and I watch every Saturday, every Nicola's game, and I know every his clubs, and nobody never react to us like yeah. And because I think that's because they're passionate and they're warm and they support family. And I think that they really respect the way that we support Nicola, and I think that's why they liked us, because they are really big supporters of him, and family is everything, and that's really, really nice. So that's why we're here, and that's why we want to support the whole club and our brother. This is very important to us, and we are so glad to be here and so happy.